In the last issue, we talked about the causes, symptoms and treatment of male pattern baldness. In this issue, we are going to talk more about hair replacement and restoration techniques. As I mentioned briefly in the last issue, hair transplantation, also known as grafting, can be a viable and more permanent solution for pattern baldness. In the past several years, there has been a great deal of progress in the field of hair replacement and restoration. Surgical techniques have improved greatly from the days when hair replacement first began. All hair replacement techniques involve the use of your own hair, therefore, hair replacement candidates must have some healthy hair, usually at the back and sides of the head. The process is a relatively safe procedure when performed by a qualified surgeon, however, as with any surgery, there are risks. Candidates must be checked for uncontrolled high blood pressure, blood clotting problems, or skin that scars excessively, as these conditions may make healing difficult. Small pieces of hair-growing scalp grafts are removed from areas of the scalp with healthy hair and are placed where hair is thinning. There are three major types of grafts: punch grafts, mini grafts, and micro grafts. Punch grafting takes about 10 to 15 hairs and places them in the scalp. This was the first type of technique to be developed, and when first developed caused a patchy look in many candidates. This technique has been improved since the first days of being developed, and the new mini graft technique has also been added as an option. Mini grafts contain only 2 to 4 hairs per graft, and therefore look much more natural. Micro grafts are still smaller grafts that contain 1 to 2 hairs each. To maintain healthy circulation of the scalp, grafts are placed 1/8 of an inch apart. Local anesthesia is usually sufficient for these procedures, and several procedures are usually required to achieve the desired result. Post-surgery, a period of approximately 10 days of no sexual or strenuous activity is recommended, as strenuous activity may cause bleeding from the graft areas. Of course, surgery is a serious option, and often an expensive one as well. For those not wishing to undergo surgery for either reason, the option of non-surgical hair additions is often explored. Many professionals have developed techniques to add hair to existing hair on your scalp that look very natural. Weaves, fusions, bonding, cabling and microlinking are some of the techniques used to bond hair to the existing hair or scalp non-surgically. Many jokes were made in the past about wigs and toupees, and they have gained an unfavorable light amongst many people because they were so obvious on the wearer. Today's toupees and wigs are often made of real hair and are very well styled, causing them to look more natural on the wearer. These hairpieces are held in place by affixing adhesive to the scalp and stay in place through vigorous exercise. Structured hairpieces, as they are called, are a semi-surgical approach that permanently attaches hair to the scalp by stitching the hair to the bald scalp. This procedure isn't recommended, as it's a process that involves introducing a foreign material to the scalp. Most ethical surgeons don't perform this procedure any longer, as they are generally deemed to be ethically inappropriate. If this procedure is recommended to you, get a second opinion from a trusted physician. A much safer procedure is hair weaving, yet this can only be used if hair is thinning and large balding areas aren't present. The process is also called hair intensification or hair integration. Strands of synthetic or real hair are braided or weaved into your own existing hair, giving an appearance of a full head of hair. Keep in mind that this method is usually expensive and can only be left in for a few weeks at a time. It's usually impractical for the average person. Make sure you look for your next issue soon. We will be talking about proven products that help combat hair loss for both men and women.